In order to find the forces in truss members HI, FI, and EF, we can utilize the method of section, in which we basically make a cut along the members in which we are interested in, and then separate the structure into two halves. There we have created a section along the three members HI, FI, and EF. Now we can pick any one of those two halves in order to figure out the reactions along those members. In this case, we will be interested in picking the smaller half since it will be easier to solve. Now, along those halves, we have a support reaction at G, that is a roller, and we need to first identify what are those support reactions. So let's consider the whole structure and write our equilibrium equation. In order to find the support reaction at G, I can write the summation of moment at point A equals to zero and solve for G of Y, which is coming 12.66 kilonewtons. Now let's go ahead and draw the free body diagram of the smaller section. Since here we have made a cut along the members HI, FI, and EF, the internal forces will become exposed. Since it is a truss, that is a two-force member, so we will only have the force acting along the axis of these members as F of HI, F of FI, and F of EF. Other than these internal forces, I have one external force of 6 kN that is applied at point F, and then we have a support reaction at G that we have calculated as 12.66 kN. Now once we have identified the forces, we can also identify the direction of the two forces acting along the axis of these members. So for force FF of I, since the base of the triangle is 2 and the perpendicular distance is 3, so the hypotenuse can be calculated using the Pythagorean theorem, that is coming 3.6. Next, we have that force F of HI, it is making a triangle of 3, 4, and 5. Since everything has been identified, let's go ahead and write the equilibrium equation. I can start by writing the summation of moment at point F equals to 0, taking counterclockwise as positive. Here we have a support reaction at G that will create a counterclockwise moment with a moment arm of 2. Next, we have forces 6 kN, force in the member EF, and force in the member FI. These three forces won't create any moment since they are passing through the point F. Next, the only other force that will create a moment is the horizontal component of force FHI that has a moment arm of 1.5. So adding these two forces and equating it equals to 0, we get the force in the member HI equals to negative 21.1 kN. Now, the negative sign is indicating that the direction that we have picked is the opposite direction in which the force is being applied. Since we have picked the direction in tension, the force is compression in our member HI. Next, I can write the summation of forces along the y-axis equals to 0. In this case, we have a vertical component of force FHI that can be calculated by multiplying our negative 21.11 to 3 over 5. Then I have a 6 kN going downwards. Then I have a 12.66 kN at G going in the upward direction. And finally, I have a vertical component of force F of I that can be calculated by multiplying the magnitude of force by 3 over 3.6. Simplifying, we get the force along the members FI as 7.2 kN. Finally, we can figure out the force in the member EF by writing summation of forces acting along the horizontal direction equals to 0. Here, other than the force EF, we will have the horizontal component of force in the member F of I that we can calculate by multiplying 7.2 to 2 over 3.6, and also the horizontal component of force in the member HI, which we can find by multiplying the force magnitude of negative 21.11 to 4 over 5. This gives us the force in the member EF as 12.88 kN.